Welcome back, friends. Today update is validation framework. I have done validation framework and exception handling part of billing system. Now we're going to see how we're going to integrate validation framework using registration flow. This is the request for registration flow. Let me open in the code itself. Main resource. So this is the request for registration flow for customer, employee and vendor. Okay, for customer, we don't have to give first name, middle name, last name, email ID. Only mobile number is enough. When you go to supermarket or any other shop, they'll ask only mobile number. They mostly don't ask first name, last name and email ID and all. Mostly. So I want to keep these fields and these fields, even address field, I want to keep optional. I want to keep only mobile number as a mandatory for customer. But for vendor and employee, I want to keep every fields mandatory. I want to keep every fields mandatory except landmark. Okay. Now we're going to see how to integrate this validation using Spring Boot validation framework. If you want to do if you want to integrate validation framework, first we need to add this annotation, add this artifact. There is one active artifact called Spring Boot Starter Validation. Spring Boot Starter Validation, we need to add this artifact. Okay, I have added this. Then second one is, we need to add at valid annotation in the request method parameter. Here update employee is a request method in our backend system. In that method, we need to add at valid annotation. Using this annotation, we are enabling validation for user DTO object. Third step is, inside user DTO, we have several attributes. Whatever attribute, whatever property you want to validate, for that field, we need to mention appropriate validation annotation. Spring Boot provides several validation annotation. You can use whatever you want. In my case, I want to use empty check for email ID, first name, last name and a mobile number. So I am using one validation annotation called at not blank check particular field is empty or not. Okay, so far we have completed half of the configuration for validation. Next step is, we need to create one class. I created one class called billing exception handler. That class extends from response entity exception handler. This particular class is provided by Spring Boot. We need to create one handler class. That handler class must extend from this particular class. It is a response entity exception handler. Then this controller, then this class must annotated with at risk controller, then at controller advice. These two annotations we have to add part of this class. Then if you want to add validation, if you want to implement validation, we need to override one method. That method is called handle method argument not valid. Handle method argument not valid. This method is available in this class, this parent class. We need to override this method here. Then we need to write our own logic to validate each attribute in our request body. Okay. Whenever user send a request, let's say I am passing first name as a empty. Okay. First name as a empty. What will happen? Because of this at valid annotation, Spring Boot automatically call this handler method. Once Spring Boot validation framework invoked this message, the actual error returned to client side. The client side could be Postman, Angular, React, or whatever it is. In our Postman client, I am keeping first name, last name, mobile number as a empty. Well, now these three information consider as a errors. That three information maintained in method argument not valid exception. Arguments is a type of this particular class. Through this arguments variable, I am calling one method called getBindingResult. This getBindingResult contains all the error information which we made in the client side. As of now, we are making three errors: first name, last name, mobile number. We are making three errors by passing empty value. Now that three errors available inside a binding result. From the binding result object, there is a method called getAllErrors. This getAllErrors returns a list object. That list object contains objectError class. This objectError class contains the error information about the each field. I am making empty first name. I am making empty what? First name, last name, mobile number. I am making empty first name, last name, and the mobile number, right? So three fields I am making as an error. So three object error returned here. Three object error class returned here. The three object error available in the list. I am iterating the that list using for loop. From the object error, there is a method called getDefaultMessage. This getDefaultMessage return a string value. That string value coming from here. In the at not blank annotation, I am passing error message. That error message returned by this getDefaultMessage. I am taking that default message in string value, string variable. That string variable I am adding to my own list object called validation messages. Once added all the error, in our case we have three errors, right? So three errors will going to add inside that validation message list. After adding that three error, I am returning response entity by passing this validation message, and I am saying this request is a bad request through http status dot bad request. Now whenever client send a request, this method get invoke. The three error return to in our client side. Now we'll going to see the demo. Already I tested this. Now I'll going to add email ID also. Oh, sorry, server is not started. Here I'm checking email ID also. So I keeping email ID also empty now. Server is started now. Now I'm going to send the request. See here, I'm getting error message for each field. That is, this error message coming from this get all errors. Now the four error message available here. From that object I am taking the string value. The string value I am adding to my array list. That array list I am returning in the form of response entity. Then I am saying that it's a bad request. Here it's a bad request. So this validation happening only for employees and vendors. I want to do only for employee vendors. See here, the save user DTO I am using for employee, customer, and vendor. And I added this validation for this user DTO. But I want to perform this validation only employees and vendors, not for customer, because customer can give only mobile number, not all the information. So how to handle the situation? Nothing, it's very simple. We should not add at valid. We should not add at valid annotation. If you not adding at validation, even if you add, even if you enable the validation, validation will not work. In the case of customer, I have not added at valid, so validation never happened. Validation never happened. Instead of that, validation, I am doing my own validation. When you check line number 40, I am calling one method called validate method from customer validator. Customer validator is my own class. In this class, I have one method called validate. I am passing user DTO. Inside user DTO, I am checking mobile number is empty. User DTO equal to not equal to null. The user DTO type equal to customer. The flow is customer. Then only I am checking only mobile number. If it is mobile number is empty, I am throwing the validation error message. This is my custom validation. This is my custom validation. I don't want to validate other field like a first name, last name and all. Okay. For this particular customer endpoint, I am not using the Spring Boot validation framework. For customer, I am using my own validation class. For employees and vendors, I am using validation framework. That's it guys about the validation framework. The same validation I am going to apply for all the flow. Whatever model I am going to developing part of Spring Boot application, I am going to use the same validation framework. No changes. In the next video, I am going to talk about how to implement generic exception handling using Spring Boot exception handler. Please share this channel to your friend circle. Please follow me on medium.com. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.